warm greetings to everyone. I hope in earlier video you have been observed that a new chapter, business and industry. We shall move on that same session, business and industry, the continued session and a joyful learning for you all. Have attention on this video, you will get each and every information. Dear learners, I try my level best to simplify the unit as much as possible. In this way, if you learn simplified the units in your social science textbook, you will get easily the marks on an examination point of view, I am telling. Anyhow, we shall move on the concept business and industry. I hope you got the points. What are the different kinds of trades? See, the trade is categorized into three main types. First one is home trade, second one is foreign trade, third one is entrepot trade. I will give you the meaning of these different types of trades. The first one is home trade. The trade that is existed in the country, that is called as home trade. Means home trade is an internal activity. Foreign trade means vice versa of home trade. Means the trade between the two countries, it is called as foreign trade. Home trade, it is called in the another name, that is called as native trade. We can define that in your textbook, that is mentioned as home trade. However, we can define that, we can have the name of native trade. I hope you have cleared the point of home trade. Home trade, it is an internal trade. Foreign trade means it is an external trade. What about entrepot trade? The trade which belongs to the commercial activities is called as entrepot trade. I hope this map is clear. The next one, this map has been increased to another level. The home trade is categorized into another forms, that is called as retail trade. See, again, the retail trade have another forms. One is permanent shops, another one is mobile shops. Retail trade have another types. One is permanent shops, another one is mobile shops. In permanent shops, the people have fixed place. Means what? People have fixed areas and they can sell their goods to the people. They can sell the goods to the consumers with an expectation of consumers, with the taste of consumers, they sell their goods to the customers. In mobile shops, for example, I can give example for permanent shops, landline phone. I hope everybody knows that landline phone. Means we can't carry land phone from one place to another place. That phone has a fixed place. But here in another form of retail shops, mobile shops. Mobile shops don't have fixed areas, fixed place. Means our mobile also, wherever I wanted to carry the mobile, we can that. For example, I can keep my mobile phone in my pocket. You can carry my mobile to your home. I can carry your mobile to my home. It is easy. But if you have landline in your home, we can't replace the landline again and again. So we can give that example. Permanent shops have fixed place. Mobile shops don't have fixed places. So again here, I can give example for mobile shops in this session. So in mobile shops, for example, hackers. See, hackers carry goods on their heads and they sell the products from one street to another street. Or it may possible to sell their products from one place to another place. Another one is market sellers. For example, in a town areas, in a city areas, once in a week, there is an assemble of group of different commercial activities to place. Means in the market, assembling in different areas once in a week, in that particular place, in that particular market, whatever the consumers they expected to their daily consumption, that is possible. So that's why the people, they can visit the market and they can buy different kinds of goods for their livelihood. Another one is peddlers. I hope you knew that a wheeled cart man, he visits home to home, he visits shop to shop and he sells the different kinds of goods. For example, vegetables, for example, plastic items, for example, steel items, the different kinds of items he sells from one place to another place on a wheeled cart. That is also an example of mobile shops. How means? Can you guess this, dear all the learners? Means a wheeled cart has no permanent place. Or else, one thing I can give clarity for you all. If wheeled cart has a permanent place and if a man sells different kinds of goods in a particular place in a daily routine, that is called as permanent shop. I can give this. You must have the clarification yourself. If peddler have the permanent place with him, or wheeled cart has permanent place. For example, so many different kinds of centers are there. Egg rice centers and fruit shops, all these different kinds of centers are there in your areas or in your surroundings. In that surroundings, that is called as permanent shop, we can call it, because it has its permanent place itself. If that wheeled cart it moves from one place to another place, we can call it the name it as mobile shop. Another one, wholesale traders. For example, in a city area, a person, means a retailer, he purchases different kinds of goods and services. Then he visited to village to village. He sells the goods and the services. It is called as wholesale system or wholesale traders. The next one is footpath traders. Wherever the people, a group of people or a city area, crowd area it is existed, in that particular area, dear children, I hope you can see all these systems. If you visit in your town, you can visit in your town clearly based on the concept of business. You will know about each and every systems. The footpath traders, they are assembled in a footpath areas, wherever the people, means wherever the assemble of group of people is existed, then they sell their goods, for example, vegetables, fruits, some other mobile items, some other mobile packages, some other different kinds of plastic items, they can sell the footpath areas wherever the group of assembly of people are existed. So that is called as footpath traders. Footpath traders also, they don't have fixed places. So in this way, I hope this concept is clear in your mind, because whenever you can touch my concept towards in your daily routine, you can able to easily understand each and everything. So one thing I am telling dear children from this video, it is no need to learn something, because whatever is existed in the society, I can deliver in front of you. So that's why this subject is very easy to learn, this subject is very easy to analyze. So I hope the points are very clear, that one is permanent shops, another one is mobile shops. Mobile shops again classified into various types. Mobile shops are categorized into various types. Permanent shops, like whatever it may be, the wholesale traders and different kinds of traders, if they have permanent places with them, that shop is called as permanent shop, that trade is called as permanent trade. So next one is anthropoid trade, that it belongs to the commercial activities. In your textbook, there is no information about anthropoid trade. Anyhow, I can give you a brief information about anthropoid trade. Anthropoid trade, it is the trade that is related to the commercial activities, that is related to the commercial exchange of goods and services. So in this way, I hope these points are very clear in your mind, and I hope it is called as a joyful learning for you all. So you must have these concepts in your mind. You must have this kind of mind map in your mind, mind map yourself. You can clarity each and everything. There is no need to read the textbook, there is no need to read the practice, the notebook, there is no need to write the points in your rough notebook. So in the next level, in the next session, we will discuss about industry. This is very important concept, examination point of view. This point is very important, means you will be able to learn what is industry, what are the types of industry, in another session, in another video. Thank you one and all for your kind cooperation. I will be with you always. Thank you one and all. Bye bye. Take care.